Hello, I'm Dave Iniski, and you're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel. In the video today, we're looking at what exactly the uvula does for you. Hanging from the back edge of your soft palate, the palatine uvula seems to serve several functions, none of which are particularly necessary for most people. This is why it can generally be removed with few, if any, noticeable side effects. In fact, in the West, the uvula, name deriving from the Latin uvola, meaning a small bunch of grapes, is often cut out as a part of uvula palatopharyngoplasty to help patients who suffer from sleep apnea. Other cultures have long removed the uvula to treat all manner of throat conditions, as well as cure everything from vomiting and diarrhea to rejecting breastfeeding, growth retardation, and even anorexia. Today, the surgery is still occasionally practiced among various ethnic groups in Eritrea, Ethiopia, Kenya, Niger, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, and Zarma. So if you probably wouldn't notice anything particularly different when it's removed, what does the uvula actually do and why do we still have one? Beyond that, it's necessary for producing important sounds, sometimes called uvular consonants, in several languages, including French and Arabic. Perhaps the most noticeable role of the uvula is helping to keep the throat moist. You see, the uvula is packed with serous and seromucous glands. When muscle fibers in the uvula contract, it results in these glands excreting significant amounts of a thin form of saliva that gets splattered and dripped around the throat as we speak and swallow. In fact, one of the potential side effects of having your uvula removed is occasional problems with a dry throat. With the help of its internal muscular fibers, the uvula also aids the soft palate in sealing off the passageway between your throat and your nose, called the nasopharynx, when you swallow and speak, helping to make sure bits of food or liquid don't go up your nose and that the air and vocal vibrations are directed out of your mouth and not your nasal cavity. The partial role the uvula has in this has led some to speculate that it assists with keeping the tone of our voices in a pleasing range, as it could help control both the resonance and subdue the nasal tone of the voice. However, the soft palate alone is usually perfectly capable of sealing the nasopharynx, and thus, in most cases, the uvula is not necessary to put an end to a nasally sounding voice. In rare cases, some individuals do have a problem with this, a condition called velopharyngeal insufficiency, which, beyond potential issues like nasal regurgitation, bits of food and the like going up your nose when swallowing, results in the individual having difficulty saying consonants like B. Given these primary functions of the uvula, it's been proposed that the reason humans have a uvula is because it aids somewhat in speech, making it an accessory speech organ. This theory is loosely supported by the fact that, outside of humans, only a few animals, and this is individual animals, not species, have ever been found to have one. Another function of the uvula relates to its role in the gag reflex, as it's one of only five parts of the body that'll potentially trigger it, the others being the roof of the mouth, the backs of the tongue and throat, and the tonsils. Having something that dangles down over the throat opening that can trigger this is obviously beneficial over just the tissue around said opening performing this function. However, as with other stuff the uvula does for you, it isn't really necessary in this case either, and for most people, its removal would not likely inconvenience them in the slightest, or even necessarily be noticed at all, other than potentially visually. So thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, please click that like button below, and if you're new to Today I Found Out, don't forget to click that subscribe button for more interesting videos like this one. Thanks for watching.